Hello and welcome to Chairside Live. I'm Megan Strong.
And I'm Will Schmidt, registered dental assistant here at Gladwell Dental.
Well, we're so glad you're here today because in this show, Dr. Muresan has a patient in her chair who suffered a traumatic failure of an endodontically treated tooth in the anterior.
Today, Megan, we're going to go from the beginning stages, the extraction, the bone graft, the full arch smile transitions appliance, the biotemps, to the final restorations, a BruxZir Esthetic veneer on number 7, and a BruxZir Esthetic bridge from 8 to 10.
Perfect. And you know what? To complicate matters, the patient also had a congenitally missing tooth.
That's insane.
Yeah, so Dr. Muresan had to do a special prep, so let's see how it gets done.
For the first time in many years, Maria is all smiles. It is a dramatic difference from where she was just 4 months ago. When she arrived to my office, she was so self-conscious, I could barely get her to open her mouth. Simply daily tasks like talking and eating had become problematic due to the fractured tooth that was barely attached by an endodontic post. During Maria's initial examination, I noticed her central incisal number 9 was out of alignment, unstable, and extruded. It was so mobile that during our initial visit, Maria was afraid it would fall out while she spoke. After conducting a true diagnostic examination, the X-ray showed a vertical root fracture, leaving the number 9 central incisal malaligned and unstable. After consulting the patient on these factors, she opted against implant treatment. Once we discussed the remaining options, she decided on a bridge from 8 to 11 and a veneer on number 7. Because she was congenitally missing tooth number 10, placing a bridge to restore the edentulous area required preparing the adjacent canine and reshaping it to look like the missing lateral. I selected BruxZir Esthetic Solid Zirconia as the best material to restore her beautiful smile. Sometimes clinicians think it is risky to do an all-ceramic bridge, but with a strong material like BruxZir Esthetic that has an average flexural strength of 870 megapascals, doctors can confidently seat an anterior bridge that will produce long-lasting results. Upon further evaluation, I determined that additional restoration were failing, including a composite on lateral incisal number 7. A previous root canal and post left tooth number 9 compromised, resulting in a sizable fracture. Because this fractured tooth went untreated for an extended time, vertical and horizontal bone loss was evident. Due to the hopeless state of tooth number 9, I extracted it and removed the source of infection. Upon removal, significant bone loss was observed. I used the ice cream cone guided bone regeneration technique, including the use of Nupur Biologics resorbable collagen membrane. I then filled the socket with Nupur Biologic mineralized corticocancellous allograft. This guided bone regeneration technique required approximately 3 months for the site to heal. The extraction site left an unusual large space because the patient was congenitally missing her upper left lateral and her canine number 11 was now shifted into that position. Therefore, I scanned the patient with an iTero element intraoral scanner and asked the lab to fabricate a smile transition full arch provisional so the patient and I could get a visual indication of the design of the final restoration. The pontic in the number 9 position could then guide the healing of the tissue. For the first 72 hours, I kept number 9 pontic of the smile transition appliance 2 mm away from the tissue so it would not interfere with the healing process of the surgical site. I instructed the patient to return to my office after 72 hours so that I could increase the height of the pontic and construct an ovate design that would begin contouring the tissue to create the appearance that the final restoration is naturally emerging from the gingiva. After the 3 months of wearing the smile transition appliance, the pontic had nicely contoured the tissue and the patient was ready to move forward with the final restorative treatment. I removed the existing crown on tooth number 8 and used the tooth as an abutment to support the BruxZir Esthetic bridge for teeth 8 to 11. Because tooth number 10 was missing and tooth number 11 was in its position, I prepared tooth number 11 and shaped it to support a crown that resembled a lateral. After preparation, I perform a gingivectomy in the apical region of teeth 7 and 8 to even out the gingival height. I then reline and cemented biotin provisionals, which were fabricated by the lab and helped manage her tissue during the healing process. The patient came in for a series of post-procedural appointments until I was satisfied that the tissue had healed nicely and created an harmonious gingival display. The patient received a BruxZir Esthetic bridge to replace extracted tooth number 9 because she did not want an implant. The canine number 11 was then shaped to appear as if were number 10 in the bridge span, and the bicuspid number 12 was cosmetically shaped to resemble the canine as it occupies the position. These before and after images illustrate the dramatic transformation. The goal was to create a natural look smile. Her BruxZir Esthetic veneer and bridge have given her a new lease on life. Now she is no longer afraid to share her smile with the world. Let's look at her reaction seeing her smile for the first time.
Oh my God.
Why are you crying?
Because I'm just really thankful. You send your love
to Max. Oh my. Thanks for watching.
Well, thank you so much for that, Dr. Muresan.
And that wraps it up for today's episode. So on behalf of Will and I and everyone here at Glidewell Dental, thank you so much for watching.
And we're going to meet you right back here next time.